quick, I want to make sure as we start this day that we do recognize we've laid the foundation, protected our freedom, our liberty. Last night, I had the privilege to pick my wife up. Her flight, unfortunately, she was on the same flight that Senator McCain was on, got canceled. I picked her up in Mobile, and there was two young sailors that were there, lost, trying to figure out how to get to the Seabees base in Gulfport. I had the privilege to take them to dinner and be reminded, you know what, we've got the greatest Americans in every generation. Those two 20-year-old boys reminded me of the sacrifice of my brother and other countless young men and women who've served in Iraq and Afghanistan, my uncles and others who've served in Vietnam and Korea, my grandfathers in World War II. Americans are never afraid to stand in the gap to protect our freedoms, our rights, and our liberties. And this morning, if you've served, I want to make sure that we recognize you. Do we have any members of the U.S. Coast Guard? Those of you that have served, our Coast Guard, we want to make sure we say thank you for your service. Marine Corps, I know we got a lot of Marines here, a lot of you on stage. All right, ground pounding U.S. Army veterans, would you please stand and let us say thank you.
Let us bind together. Let us re-energize the forces as we face our tomorrows with valiant faith, that you are God and you know where we are. For it's in Jesus' name we pray, and everyone said amen.
Amen.
Now join me in the Pledge of Allegiance to our flag. Attention.
Salute. Flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. You can be seated today. Thank you so much. What a great way to begin our time together. Most importantly, for some of the individuals I have the privilege to stand here on this stage with, our veterans, those of you, thank you so much for your service and for your leadership and for being here. Well, friends, I get the privilege to introduce to you several dear friends of mine and colleagues that I have the privilege to work with and serve with. The first of those individuals is a dear friend, not only of the 3rd Congressional District, but all of Mississippi. I have the privilege of serving the Mississippi Air National Guard, and I watched tirelessly as he and his staff worked to return a heritage of in-air refueling to Meridian, Mississippi. Congressman Greg Harper, Congressman of the 3rd Congressional District. Y'all make him welcome.
So many veterans and the things that Senator Thad Cochran has done and our special guest, Senator John McCain, but a point of personal privilege. I want to personally thank Senator Cochran because many of you know I have a child with special needs and how many times we've had to work on those issues in Washington, D.C., and he has been there for my family, for every family with special needs, and I want to say thank you, Senator Cochran. The 186 in Meridian, Mississippi, the air refueling wing, we went through a round of RAC and we lost the KC-135 super tankers that really had their tradition from the Key Brothers back in the late 1920s in Meridian, Mississippi. We were in danger of not even having an enduring flying mission there. And now when you go down I-20 and you look to your right as you're heading towards the Alabama line, you can see those beautiful KC-135 super tankers sitting over there on the runway that we would not have had but for the efforts of Senator Thad Cochran. And we thank you for that. Senator Cochran deserves to be reelected for all he's done in the past for Mississippi. But the reason he should be reelected is because of what he means for the future of Mississippi. We can do so much more.
Serving with Lieutenant Governor Tate Reeves day in and day out at Mississippi Cap, and I have watched Tate fight fearlessly for our veterans and our military communities, our defense contractors, to make sure there's an environment so that they can provide not only the jobs for Mississippi families, the employment that we so desperately need to watch grow, but also for the stability of the defense of our nation through the hard work of these men and women, our neighbors, our fellow Mississippians. So help me make welcome our Lieutenant Governor, Tate Reeves.
Thank y'all. Thank y'all. Stacy, thanks for those kind remarks. Thanks to all of you for being here today. And thank you to these gentlemen that are sitting behind me. Because the thing that they all have in common is they fought so that my kids and your kids and my grandkids and your grandkids could live in the greatest country in the history of the earth. When we traveled around the state back in 2011 campaigning and asking each of you for your vote, Governor Bright and I and all the other elected officials heard the same thing. And that is our number one priority must be job creation, bringing better and higher paying jobs to our state. But you see, we have a political philosophy which says government does not create jobs. Government's role is to create an environment which encourages the private sector to invest capital and create jobs. And the progress we've made in doing just that under Governor Bryan's leadership is remarkable. But we've done it because we've had partners in Washington, D.C. Partners like Senator Thad Cochran, who helped ensure that our defense contractors that come from private sector capital investment, whether they're in Jackson County or in Scott County or in the Golden Triangle, that they're continuing to invest money in our state, creating jobs in our state, creating wages and a better economy in our state of Mississippi. Without Thad Cochran's leadership, that would not be possible. Without Thad Cochran's determination, and without his position of importance, that would not be possible. I told many of you when I was able to speak on the campaign trail for Senator Cochran over the last 6, 8, 10 weeks, it's pretty simple for me. All of us that are statewide elected officials are supporting Thad Cochran. We're unanimously supporting Thad Cochran. The conservative leaders of our state are standing with Thad Cochran. And for me, the reason for that is simple. I have three reasons. Their ages are 9, 7, and 2. Their names are Tyler, Emma, and Maddie. Those are my three daughters. You see, Ely and I grew up in small Mississippi towns. We went to Mississippi public high schools. We graduated from a Mississippi college. And then we got out and we got jobs in Mississippi. I want my three daughters to have the same opportunities that we had, and I think the election tomorrow is imperative to ensuring that they have that opportunity. Tomorrow, I believe we as Mississippians are going to do what these fine men and women that have served our country have done. We're going to come together as a state. We're going to come together as Mississippians. And we're going to make sure that my children's future and your children's future is brighter. And the way we're going to do that is we're going to send Thad Cochran back to the United States.
I'm sitting here on stage, and here on the front row are some of the most well-behaved, cutest.
Oh, amen.
Anybody want to guess who the granddaddy is? Patriotic young kids of that next generation. And I do get to introduce their grandfather, my friend, your friend, U.S. Air Force veteran, even if he was a JAG officer. Y'all help me welcome our friend, U.S. Senator Roger Wicker. Tomorrow.
athlete, and John McCain and I have to get on a plane. But, you know, I love the First Amendment, Brother Pastor. I love freedom of speech. And it allows people to come before you on television and say anything they want to, no matter how ridiculous it is. So Gail and I flipped on the television this morning, and somebody came on and said, if that Cochran can't get it done in 40 years, it's time for him to come home. Let me tell you, ladies and gentlemen, Thad Cochran gets it done for tomorrow until 7 p.m., we're going to make sure we get it done for Thad Cochran. Big round
of well, friends, now I get to introduce to you my predecessor. Phil Bryant served as state auditor. He knows every corner of the state, every aspect, every small city, county, school district, and largest state agency. He took that knowledge to the lieutenant governor's office, and then took it right across the road to the governor's office. Now, let me tell you, my fellow veterans, and those of you who love our veterans so dearly, one of the first conversations I had with our governors whenever they came down with the idea of sequestration, they came out with the idea of, let's do a new BRAC. The first thing our governor did was call up General Freeman and everybody else and put together our committee of Mississippians to protect Mississippi jobs, Mississippi military bases, and Mississippi servicemen and women. Our governor cares about our veterans. He's demonstrated time and time again. So friends, help me welcome our governor, Phil Bryant.
Americans. In fact, this group of Americans that are behind me and those that sit in the audience and those that are all across the state of Mississippi that truly can be called patriots because they put on the uniform of the United States of America and went forward. On Memorial Day, I visited one of those. He was a 17-year-old CB out of Sullivan's Hall. On his gravestone was United States Navy. U.S.C. Bryant. My dad and I had a conversation that day before I went to the memorial in Rankin County Courthouse to join a congressman and others. And I could hear him just as plainly as when he was alive and we talked. He said, son, we've got to save this nation. Men and women in Washington, D.C. must stand for our veterans. They must stand for our flag, our beliefs, as Americans. I left there that day committed to understand that how we honor our veterans will be how this country is honored. So today we join together with two great veterans who served as my dad did in the United States Navy. Yeah, my dad would be proud, an old Navy guy, to make sure I got up here to honor these two Navy guys. But you see, as I was also in the shipyards on Friday as the USS Tripoli's keel was being laid, as I was over at Lakota Helicopters in Columbus, Mississippi, Airbus Helicopters, watching that 300th Lakota helicopter being brought off the line for our war fighters, as I met with the leaders of Winchester, making those important basic ammunition for our military around the world, I understood just how important it was that we re-elect Thad Cochran to the United States Senate.
Yes!
Now, I can tell you, ladies and gentlemen, lives depend upon it. Now, I know how important our defense industries have come to us how important our military bases are and the men and women that serve there. But as I was sitting here this morning, I noticed Amber's sign. Just thank you for supporting my dad, Major Greg Benning. Of all the money that's been spent, of all the people that have been airdropped in here, of all the things that you've heard, good and bad, all the people that just say this is going to happen and how we're going to change history forever, the history of Thad Cochran is thank you for supporting my dad.
Not just in a military officer sense, but as sincere patriots in every respect. On every day in the United States Senate, we get to see John McCain in action. And if you don't want to get more over or embarrassed, you better get out of the way or agree with him. He is a man of conviction. He is a person of great courage. He is a person of great stature. And it is a privilege and an honor for me to introduce to you my colleague from the United States Senate, John McCain.
Once, I think it was Harry Truman that said, if you want a friend in Washington, go out and buy a dog. I want to say that you have a friend in Washington, and I have a friend in Washington, a man of distinction, of service, of honor, integrity, a man we must send tomorrow. Yeah! I would like to mention again, I'm proud and honored, and I can't tell you what a wonderful state I represent in the state of Arizona. It's a little hot there today, but in fact, my predecessor, Barry Goldwater, used to say we have so little water in Arizona, the trees chase the dogs. I'm so proud. But I'm also incredibly proud of the roots of my family that go back many, many generations here in this wonderful state. I can't tell you how proud I am of their service to this great state and the nation, including the 2 years that I spent as a flight instructor at Naval Air Station Meridian, McCain Field, some of the really happy times of my life. So I really do consider Mississippi my second state, and I'm very proud to be here. What a joy it is to have also the privilege of serving with Roger Wicker, a great guy and a great advocate. Despite the fact that he was in the Air Force. I want to thank our veterans. Thank you, my friends. Roger, thank you. Dad, thank you for not mentioning that I ran for president of the United States. After I lost, I slept like a baby. Sleep 2 hours, wake up in pride. Thank you for your outstanding service. Thank all of you, and thank you, Governor Bryan. I spent some time with Governor Bryan on Romney campaign, and by the way, I can't help but remember the story of the two inmates in the chow line in the state prison, and one of them turned to the other and said, "The food was a lot better in here when you were governor." you can't tell that joke in Illinois, but thanks for the great job. Yesterday I was supposed to be down in Gulfport, and thanks to the vagaries, and I won't mention the airline, I got to spend 5 pleasant hours in the airport of Dallas-Fort Worth, but I was sorry that I was not there, because, you know, what the ships they build there and what they do are so integral to the defense of this nation. Ingalls does a tremendous job, and this is the person who has stood up for them and the ships that they build. Military bases and our guard and our veteran. There, look, we cannot afford not to have this experience handed the tiller in the most dangerous times that I have ever seen in my lifetime. A reckless foreign policy that is allowing this nation to be threatened as never before by the forces of radical extremists who are hell-bent on destroying this nation. We cannot afford to have someone brand new to learn on the job. This is the person who can lead this nation in these most difficult and challenging times, with a president who does not understand what American national security is all about. A president who does not understand. We need to have a man who is an advocate, who is a veteran, who served with honor in the United States Navy, as Thad Cochran has. A person who I sat down with after this terrible scandal in the VA, which began in the Phoenix VA and has spread throughout the country. Allegations in Phoenix that 40 veterans died while waiting for care, and the scandal spreads. And as gridlocked as we are in Washington, as little that we do, Thad Cochran and I sat down together and we worked out a veterans bill that will give veterans choice that passed by 93-3. Yeah. veterans, and I want to mention that I often say when I'm with my dear veteran friends that when I graduated from the Naval Academy, I tried to get in the Marine Corps, but my parents were married. Now, that's a pretty funny joke, and I use it a lot till my son, Jim, joins the Marine Corps, comes home after finishing boot camp in San Diego and tells me, he said, "Dad, you know that the Marines are part of the Navy Department, the men's department." And so I guess we had a senator from Arizona who served for a long time. His name was Carl Hayden, and he made a very profound statement. He said, "You know, in the United States Senate, we have two kinds of senators, workhorses and show horses." And I guarantee you, when Carl Hayden said that about workhorses, he was talking about that. We don't need anyone right now with the situation in the world in our defense and our continued cuts in our defense and continued reduction in our readiness, our capabilities to defend this nation all over the world. We need someone who's right there in the position that I, as chairman of the Armed Services Committee, when we take control of the Senate, can work with Thad Cochran side by side, cheek by jowl, in making sure that this nation restores its greatness and strength, which is being eroded by this president of the United States, who is not I have to remind you of something right now that I think you may not totally understand. Not only the eyes of the nation be on this election tomorrow, the eyes of the world will be on this election. Because this election tomorrow will send a message as to whether we can rely on a proven record of leadership, a proven record of dedicated service to the people of Mississippi and this nation or not. And so there's a lot more at stake here than just that election. But the most important thing is this nation right now needs Thad Cochran in the leadership position which he has assumed and which he has served this nation so honorably. And I'll be very proud. I'll be very, very proud to spend the next few years with one of the most decent, fine, honorable men that I have ever had the privilege of knowing in the United States Senate. So I urge you, our fellow veterans, our service members, family, our guard members, who understand that Thad Cochran plays a critical role in these most difficult and challenging times. So I call on my fellow veterans, and I call on my fellow service members to send Thad Cochran, a good and decent and honorable servant, back to the United States Senate. Thank you.
Someone with you to vote in honor of a veteran. Thank you so much.